looks like himself a very person, a very enthusiastic person, but he cannot believe, and people here cannot believe what has happened. It was this morning, 2 years ago, 22 months ago, in July of 2016, what happened here, but once everything's been assessed here, they say the damage was worse all the way down Main Street. And right here, where I'm looking at this big hole in Connecticut Mills, part of the issue here was another burst of water came out of the woods and took out and washed away the old courthouse, which is right here next to the old cabin that started to put the church, St. Luke's Church. And then, where a lot of people park if they're going to go to Judge's Bench, one of the restaurants and bars here on Main Street, that is all mud right now. And there are probably a dozen cars covered with the mud. And within the last hour, we also found out from our county executive, Kim Minton,
who came here this morning for a few hours, that we have one missing person who has been reported. The individual's name is also put on the Howard County Police Department's website, so I can release that to you. They don't have any information about the gentleman. His name is Edison Herman, H-E-R-M-A-N-D. Edison, E-D-D-I-S-O-N. He was actually reported missing to the Howard County Department at 12:30.
And apparently, from Facebook, folks saying they are friends with Edison Herman, saying he was formerly in the Air Force, now a sergeant in the Maryland National Guard. And some witnesses here along Main Street, the lower end of Main Street, say he was actually helping rescue people, went into the water sometime after 4 o'clock. And they're saying that was the last time he was seen, Edison Herman, formerly in the Air Force, now with the Maryland National Guard. The first choice, state of emergency declared by Governor Hogan. He was here late yesterday afternoon, early in the evening, assessing the damage, and he too, just like Alan Tillman, couldn't believe what he saw as he walked down Main Street. Now, like it was 2 years ago, Main Street completely cordoned off. Yesterday, everything was going on. Our own Jane Miller from WBAL-TV at the news was able to walk down Main Street, take some amazing pictures and shoot some video that you can see on Twitter with Jane Miller. But right now, everything has been shut down because the major concern is the structures that are along Main Street. Are they still viable? They don't want anyone going into any of these buildings until the engineers can go in to find out if it'll be safe to do that. So you might remember back, that's a process they went through here in Ellicott City in 2016. So many things that these people have gone through. And later on, when we were talking to Alan Kittleman this morning, he was asked, I think by Suzanne Bumble of CNN, about people, I mean, even Lacey Griffith from WBAL-TV 11 asked him what he would say to folks who have businesses here along Ellicott City if they've decided to not reopen those businesses and just stop it because of all this. And he said he would completely understand. Though he said this is very early in this whole process, he said he completely understands that reaction by anyone here today.
Scott, I want to ask you about, in comparison to what we saw 22 months ago, there's so much more video that happened to be caught by folks that were in the area as this water rushed through. And I remember watching the video from almost 2 years ago. You could see the water rushing down Main Street, but it didn't look like it was compromising buildings. This time, you see the water rushing from the back of these buildings, out of the front doors, through the windows, and down the street. It just looks like a completely much more devastating scenario.
And there's only so much these buildings can take. I'm looking at an old Ellicott City banner that's on the street light here along Ellicott Mills Road, and it says, individually crafted since 1772. Some of these buildings dating back to the 1600s here along Main Street in Ellicott City, just to give you a sense of how old they are. And some of them were reinforced after the flooding of 2016, but gosh, only so much they could take. And one of the historic buildings, old courthouse building, right next to the old cabin right here at Ellicott Mills and Main Street, really at the top of Main Street, there wasn't damage really at all, except for the hill below St. Luke's Church 2 years ago. That's flattened. All that remains is the roof and parking lot F here in historic Ellicott City.
And that also was caught on video. You can see the building just washing away, cars piled up, and just crumpled into each other. It's just an amazing look at the force of Mother Nature.
Yeah, and there's no stopping the bomber for months ago. They found that here in Ellicott City, there were some things that have been done in the last couple of years trying to reinforce some of Main Street, and Alan Kittleman said those efforts seem to have worked where that was done, but he says it takes time. An amazing example of that was just recently, within the last few weeks, money from FEMA was just released for repairs from the damage of 2 years ago.
WBAL Scott Wyckoff in Ellicott City for us, getting our first look at all of this devastation in Ellicott City from the flooding, flash flooding yesterday. We're coming through the area. We've got much more with Scott, and of course you can check out more on our website. We've got pictures and video at WBAL.com.